In this video, we're going to finish the adding and subtracting square roots worksheet on the CUDA software website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to get to this free geometry worksheet. When adding and subtracting square roots, you can think of this as adding and subtracting like terms, or you could also reverse distribute and then solve. But before we do any of that, we have to simplify. So let's go ahead and simplify in number 12. We have a perfect square that is a multiple of 12, a perfect square that is a multiple of 27, and a perfect square that is a multiple of 45. So we know that those square roots can be simplified. So let's start with the square root of 12. We have negative 3 times the square root of 12. 2 squared is equal to 4, so 4 is the perfect square, and 4 times 3 equals 12. So we can rewrite 12 as 2 squared times 3. Then we have minus 2 times the square root of 27. 27 is a multiple of 9, and 9 is a perfect square. 9 is equal to 3 squared, so we can say 9 times 3, or 3 squared times 3, equals 27. Lastly, we're going to subtract 2 times the square root of 45. 9 is also a multiple of 45. 9 times 5 is 45, and we can think of 9 as 3 squared. So we'll have 3 squared times 5. Now I'm going to go ahead and split up the radicals. So we have negative 3 times the square root of 2 squared times the square root of 3, minus 2 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 3, minus 2 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 5. The square root of 2 squared is 2, so I have negative 3 times 2 times the square root of 3, minus 2 times the square root of 3 squared is 2 times 3, and then we have times the square root of 3. And then we'll subtract 2 times the square root of 3 squared, which is just 3, times the square root of 5. Negative 3 times 2 is negative 6 times the square root of 3, minus 2 times 3 is a positive 6 times the square root of 3, minus 2 times 3, which is 6, times the square root of 5. Now I'm going to combine negative 6 times the square root of 3, minus 6 times the square root of 3, and that's going to give me negative 12 times the square root of 3, since negative 6 minus 6 is negative 12, and we have to subtract 6 times the square root of 5 at the end. Those two terms cannot be combined, so negative 12 times the square root of 3 minus 6 times the square root of 5 is the solution in number 12. Moving on to number 13, I'm going to start by combining, and I also know that there is a perfect square that is a multiple of 45, so I'm also going to simplify this square root. So we have negative 1 times the square root of 5 plus 3 times the square root of 5, which is going to be a positive 2 times the square root of 5. And then we're adding 2 times the square root of 3 squared times 5, since 9 times 5 is 45. So we'll have 2 square root of 5 plus 2 times 3, since the square root of 3 squared is 3, times the square root of 5. So we have 3 times the square root of 5. 2 times the square root of 5 plus 2 times 3 times the square root of 5 is 6, square root of 5. And now, again, we can combine. 2 plus 6 is 8, so we'll have 8 times the square root of 5 as the final solution in number 13. In number 14, we have two square roots that we can simplify. However, as opposed to simplifying, I'm going to combine those first. Notice that negative 2 times the square root of 54 plus 2 times the square root of 54 is 0 times the square root of 54, which is 0, so all we have left is negative 3 times the square root of 6 plus 0, which is negative 3 times the square root of 6. So negative 3 times the square root of 6 is the solution in number 14, and since when we combine those terms, they canceled out, we didn't even have to simplify. In number 15, I can simplify the square root of 8, and I can simplify the square root of 27. In order to simplify the square root of 8, I'll have 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 2, since 4 times 2 is equal to 8. Then I'll have plus 2 times the square root of 27, which 3 squared times 3 is 27, since 9 times 3 is 27, and then I have plus 3 times the square root of 3. 3 times the square root of 2 squared times 2 is 3 times 2 times the square root of 2, plus 2 times the square root of 3 squared times 3 is 2 times 3 times the square root of 3, and then I have plus 3 times the square root of 3. 3 times 2 is 6, so I have 6 times the square root of 2, plus 2 times 3 is 6, so I have 6 times the square root of 3, plus 3 times the square root of 3. Now I'm going to combine. I can combine my 6 times the square root of 3 and 3 times square root of 3. So what I have is 6 times the square root of 2 plus 6 plus 3 is 9. So 6 times the square root of 3 plus 3 times the square root of 3 is 9 times the square root of 3. 6 times the square root of 2 plus 9 times the square root of 3 is my solution in number 15. In number 16, right away, we can see that negative 3 times the square root of 45 plus 3 times the square root of 45 will cancel out to be 0. So all we have left is 3 times the square root of 54. And we know that that square root of 54 can be simplified down. So we have 3 times the square root of 54, and let's simplify. We can rewrite the square root of 54 as 9, which is 3 squared, times 6. Breaking up that square root, we can say 3 times the square root of 3 squared times the square root of 6. So we'll have 3 times 3 times the square root of 6, which is 9, times the square root of 6. In number 17, we can go ahead and simplify the square root of 12 and the square root of 45. So we'll have 2 times the square root of 2 squared times 3, since 4 times 3 is 12, plus 3 times the square root, 9 times 5 is 45, so 3 squared times 5, plus 3 times the square root of 3. This leaves me with 2 times 2 times the square root of 3, plus 3 times 3 times the square root of 5, plus 3 times the square root of 3. 2 times 2 is 4, so I'll have 4 times the square root of 3, plus 3 times 3 is 9, so I'll have 9 times the square root of 5, plus 3 times the square root of 3. Then I'm going to combine 4 times the square root of 3 with 3 times the square root of 3 to get 7 times the square root of 3 plus 9 times the square root of 5. I'm going to combine my square root of 54 at the start. So I have negative 2 times the square root of 27 minus square root of 54 minus square root of 54 will be minus 2 times the square root of 54. Now I'm going to simplify each of my square roots. The square root of 27 can be rewritten as the square root of 3 squared times 3, since 9 times 3 is 27. So I have negative 2 times the square root of 27 can be rewritten as 3 squared times 3, minus 2 times the square root of 54, which can be rewritten as 3 squared times 6. Simplifying that further, I can get negative 2 times 3 times the square root of 3, minus 2 times 3 times the square root of 6. Negative 2 times 3 is negative 6 times the square root of 3, minus 2 times 3 is 6 times the square root of 6. Those two numbers cannot be combined, so I'll have negative 6 times the square root of 3 minus 6 times the square root of 6. In number 19, I can simplify each of the square roots. So I'm going to have 4 times the square root of 72. So 72 is 36 times 2, and I know that 36 is equal to 6 squared. So I have 4 times the square root of 6 squared times 2 plus 4 times the square root of 128, which 128 is equal to 64 times 2, and 64 is 8 squared. So I'll have 8 squared times 2 minus the square root of 96, which is 16 times 6. So I'll have 4 squared times 6, since 4 squared is 16, plus 4 times the square root of 8, which is 2 squared times 2. So I have 4 times 6 times the square root of 2 plus 4 times 8 times the square root of 2 minus 4 times the square root of 6 plus 4 times 2 times the square root of 2. 4 times 6 is 24 times the square root of 2 plus 4 times 8 is 32 times the square root of 2 minus 4 times the square root of 6 plus 4 times 2 is 8 times the square root of 2. Now I can combine 24 square root of 2 with 32 square root of 2 and 8 square root of 2. When I add those all together, 24 plus 32 plus 8 equals 64. So I'll have 64 times the square root of 2 minus 4 times the square root of 6. In number 20, I'm going to go ahead and simplify square root of 112, square root of 27, and the square root of 45. Negative 3 times the square root of 5 plus 3 times the square root, 4 squared times 7, since 16 times 7 is 112, plus 4 times the square root of 3 squared times 3, since 9 times 3 is 27, plus 2 times the square root of 3 squared times 5, since 9 times 5 is 45. So I'll have negative 3 square root of 5 plus 3 times 4 times the square root of 7 plus 4 times 3 times the square root of 3 plus 2 times 3 times the square root of 5. Negative 3 square root of 5 plus 3 times 4 is 12 times the square root of 7 plus 4 times 3 is 12 times the square root of 3 plus 2 times 3 is 6 times the square root of 5. Negative 3 times the square root of 5 plus 6 times the square root of 5 is positive 3 times the square root of 5. And then I have plus 12 times the square root of 7 plus 12 times the square root of 3 still left. Moving on to number 21, right away I can see that 3 times the square root of 72 minus 3 times the square root of 72 is 0. So I have negative 2 times the square root of 6 plus 4 times the square root of 7 left over, and neither of those can be simplified any further. So that is my final answer in number 21. And lastly, number 22. I'm going to start by combining 2 times the square root of 8 and 2 times the square root of 8. However, I'm going to change all my operations to addition. So I'm going to add negative 2 times the square root of 8, I'm going to add negative 4 times the square root of 6, and I'm going to add negative 2 times the square root of 8, because that will help me when combining two terms that are subtracted. So I have negative 3 times the square root of 7, plus I have negative 2 times the square root of 8, plus negative 2 times the square root of 8, which is negative 4 times the square root of 8, plus negative 4 times the square root of 6. That leaves me with negative 3 times the square root of 7, plus the square root of 8 can be rewritten as 2 squared times 2, which we know is 2 times the square root of 2. So I have negative 4 times 2 times the square root of 2 plus negative 4 times the square root of 6. And lastly, I'll have negative 3 times the square root of 7 plus negative 4 times 2, which is negative 8 times the square root of 2. So I'll subtract 8 times the square root of 2. And then, as opposed to adding negative 4 times the square root of 6, I'll subtract 4 times the square root of 6. None of those can be combined. Therefore, my final answer is negative 3 times the square root of 7 minus 8 times the square root of 2 minus 4 times the square root of 6. Don't forget to like this video and also to comment below to let me know what you think. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel so you get updated when new videos are released.